Hello! In this video, I will share with you my experience after testing HDMI eARC connection between 2019 Denon AV receiver and 2019 LG TV. eARC stands for Enhanced Audio Return Channel, and it is an improved version of the original audio return channel introduced 10 years ago with HDMI 1.4. eARC is part of the most recent HDMI 2.1 standard. The main improvement is the ability for the TV to send out uncompressed 5.1 or 7.1 surround sound, as well as high-bitrate and object-based formats like Dolby Atmos or DTS-X to the external device using HDMI cable with Ethernet functionality. This is also very convenient, as you can now use apps like Netflix or Prime Video on your TV to get the best audio quality without the need for an external device like Ultra HD Blu-ray player that would feed such content to the AV receiver or a soundbar. My investigation was done with the following components: LG 55SM9000 Ultra HD TV, Denon AVR-X1600H AV receiver, and for this test I was using several different cables, including 2-meter long Club 3D ultra high speed HDMI cable, as well as 10-meter long Feizlink active optical HDMI cable. Cables were connected to HDMI port number 2 labeled ARC on LG TV and on monitor HDMI output on the receiver. I was also using Denon AVR remote app to check input signal information, as the front display doesn't show all the information about the input I was interested in, like the number of channels in the input signal. I tested eARC in Netflix and Prime Video apps, as well as with built-in media player. Before I started, I enabled eARC option and set pass-through for the digital sound out in the audio section of the TV. The results are as follows. Netflix was sending out Dolby Digital Plus 5.1 on all content I tested, and in order to get Dolby Atmos, I had to use a little trick. I noticed that when the internal speaker was selected in the settings menu, Dolby Atmos icon would appear in Netflix. Switching to external speaker, with or without eARC option enabled, would switch the icon to 5.1. So what I did was, I would start the video with internal speaker selected, and then during playback, I would switch to external audio. This way Dolby Atmos audio was sent to the receiver, and this was confirmed in Netflix, on the front panel of the receiver, and in the Denon app. The downside is that if you stop playback and play something else, it would revert back to Dolby Digital Plus. So it's not as convenient as it should be. I guess this will be corrected in some of the future software updates, either for the Netflix app or for the TV. Regarding Amazon Prime Video, here things were working as they should. Tom Clancy's Jack Ryan was played with Dolby Atmos audio without any tricks, and other content that is not in Dolby Atmos was played in Dolby Digital Plus. Regarding the built-in media player, I tried several demos from demoworld.eu website, and for the most of them, I was able to get Dolby Atmos but not DTS-X. Instead, a standard compressed DTS was played. And that's basically all that I wanted to share with you today. This investigation confirms eARC is working with these products, but some workarounds are currently needed in the Netflix app. I'll definitely keep an eye how this will progress and test out more combinations as soon as I can. I'm sending big thank you to LG office in Croatia for providing the TV and to retailer Ronis for providing the brand new Denon receiver. Please let me know what is your experience with eARC and if there is something more you would like me to test. Thanks for watching and see you soon!